We're here today at the Intelligent Factory demo. We're gonna get a chance to really understand what's happening in the world of IoT or the Internet of Things. We're creating a new class of edge and IoT solutions. We're taking these newer IT technologies and techniques that have been developed in traditional computing, combining with OT or operational technology, and being able to drive new levels of efficiency that we really haven't been able to see before.
As we start looking at the Intelligent Factory, one of the places we start is really around digital design. And an example here, the solar light, you're looking at a CAD solution. So as Alfred's manipulating through, you can see the different components, and then you could go and make changes. And what this allows us to do is to really accelerate the overall design process around those products. So now as we move further into our Intelligent Factory, we start looking at guided assembly. So what you've got on the screen here is actually a representation of augmented reality that you would see if you were wearing the normal goggles setup. We're gonna use it to help drive the assembly. It's actually showing me to make a wire attachment. Now it's identifying the back, and it's showing how that gets placed on the light. But if you're looking at being able to add dynamic production to a factory, this technology ensures not only better job performance, but a higher output quality and still be able to support a dynamic set of product production. So as we pick up from our guided assembly, we've got a connected torque driver so that we can actually use that real-time connectivity to the tool set to not only ensure that the worker's following the right activities, but that the right requirements for this particular type of assembly is actually followed. So you can imagine doing the similar type of production assembly on, say, an airplane wing. The angle of the rivets is extremely important. So this is an example of how these sorts of technologies and tool sets can be applied, combined with things like the augmented reality to really ensure worker productivity and the level of quality is at the highest it can possibly be. So now that we've assembled our solar light, we're gonna move on to quality assurance. And in this case, we're working with our partner, Relometrics, to leverage video analytics to really help drive quality assurance. So first, I want to talk about what we're doing within our own factories. As we're moving those servers down the conveyor belt, we're doing a real-time video scan. We know section by section exactly which components are supposed to be where and exactly how they're supposed to be put together to have a fully completed server. When we implemented this, we got a 25% uplift in overall product quality. And for each server we produce, we took a minute and a half off the overall QA process. So you can imagine a factory where we're producing 45,000 servers, that picking up a minute and a half per server, that's a lot of time that we picked up throughout this whole process. So one thing to highlight here from this particular robot from ABB, this is actually what's known as a cobot. This particular design is intended to be used in conjunction with human beings. Leveraging robots is really good for repetitive processes, especially when you start thinking about industries where you've got much heavier industrial machinery like you might find in aerospace and in automotive industries. One of the most iconic pieces of any factory is the conveyor belt, because that's really what connects each of the different stations together to give you that full end-to-end process. And what we've done is we've added sensors. And what this does is this allows us to look at things like pace, like the speed, like vibration, to make sure that everything's operating the way it's supposed to operate. Even though the goal of these new sensor technologies is to make sure the conveyor belt never goes down, inevitably, there's going to be problems. And sometimes production stops. So when that happens, we have new technologies that we're able to leverage to help drive and troubleshoot and minimize the downtime from this process. So in this case, we've got Gary. He's wearing a hands-free wearable. In real time, Gary's able to connect to an expert in this particular conveyor belt who can see exactly what Gary's seeing, and they can walk through and troubleshoot the scenario, get it fixed, and then get things back up and running as soon as possible. So Gary's get the expert, and now we're back up and running again, production's flowing, and the factory's making money, and everybody's happy.
One of the other real advantages of these new edge and IoT technologies is the ability to bring all of this information together. So if we take an example and look at the dashboard behind me, what you see here is actually real-time information provided from each of the stations that we walk through. Now a plant manager can see in real time everything that's happening across the plant in total and can start to make decisions to understand if I'm having an issue or a challenge in one area, what sort of changes do I want to make in the other area to balance that out and make sure I'm still optimizing the overall output of the factory. So having the right converged, ruggedized IT in the right form factors that can go directly on the factory floor to help drive these new digital innovations is really important to our customers.